Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the cruiserweight division, all thanks to Madison Sport. And for this fight, fighting out of our red corner, weighing in at 84.4 kilos, training under Dennis Clancy as he fights out of the Hawks Boxing Club. Please welcome James Bishop. His opponent in our blue corner, weighed in at a neat 88 kilos. Training under Frankie Pianto. He fights out of the East Side Boxing Gym in West End. Please welcome Luke Modini.
We're getting set for fight number two now, Nathan. I tell you, I've been looking forward to watching this man fight again. I speak of Luke the Lover Modini. Been lucky enough to ring announce his first two fights. They haven't lasted long. I saw his last corporate fight under Frankie Pianto and Mike Loxham and the boys there from East Side. This guy is explosive. He can punch. And this will be interesting.
And it'll be a sprint again, another 4x3 minute contest, and not much time in there, so the boys will come out fast, I'd say.
But he's exciting, this boy. He's a guy I think you'll hear a little bit more of as they progress through. So great to see him on this card. You see him chomping at the bit. He's ripped and ready to go. James Bishop, the man that's in front of him here, his last two fights. Luke Modini hasn't been back on his stool to end a round, and he starts fast here.
Yeah, 100% record so far for Luke Modini. Two bouts, two wins for two big KOs. And you can see he throws him with plenty of venom.
Into the body there again. Short and straight. As he unloads here.
Yeah, he's not taking any prisoners here. He is loading up with every punch. And he is out on his feet, James Bishop. And it has been waved away with good reason.
Yeah,
because
good
Luke Modini was all over him.
Yep, so that's been a similar story to what we've seen in his first two fights.
Yep.
So not only has he not seen the stool to end round one, I don't know if the timekeeper's got past the first minute and a half. And you can see there again, he's very raw, but he's very, very explosive, and he's strong.
Very strong, yeah. Obviously, James Bishop, that was his first fight for the year, so a bit of ring rust potentially as well. Whereas Luke Modini, that was his third fight. He's been a lot more active out of these two boxes, so that makes a big difference as well. But, way too strong here tonight with Luke Modini.
So his pro career goes to 3-0 by way of stoppage. He's as I said, he's quite an exciting talent coming through now. You'll see some of the highlights here now. You see him landing here, the big southpaw.
Yeah, long-rangey fighter. Straight left was just shooting down the barrel, catching his opponent every time. And good variation to the body too. He hit him a couple times with the body and that lowered his guard and bang, the big left straight down the pipeline finished him off.
It's always great to end these fights early like that, but I'm sure for his team they'd love to see him get a bit of time in the ring because, as I said, he's a work in progress, obviously coming through that corporate fighting scene, I guess you could say, but before turning professional.
Yep.
And Nathan, you'd know better than most, it's ring craft and time in the ring. You can't get it sparring, you can't get it corporate fighting, it's actual on the job training, and that's probably something this man they'll be looking to add to his tally now.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, you see some great fighters in the gym that can't convert it into the fight night. It's just obviously the nerves, the bright lights, it catches up with a lot of people, but it looks like it had no effect here tonight for Luke Modini. Once he gets deep into the deeper water, that might change things a little bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, no need to go to the judges' scorecards for this one. Our referee, Alan Simpson, has stopped this fight at a time of 36 seconds into the very first round. And your winner, by TKO, the blue corner, Luke Modini.
Go. We'll be right back.